ETABS has many drawing tools to help create the model, and this tutorial will demonstrate a number of them. Typically, most models are constructed using either frame objects for beams, braces, and columns, or shell objects for floors and walls. Frames can be drawn using a number of different commands. If we select the Draw Beam Column Brace command, we can draw frames in any view of the model. Whenever drawing an object, a properties of object form appropriate to that object and the active view will appear. Note that when drawing an object, a property can be assigned at the same time, including a property of none. To draw a single frame in plan view, click once at the starting location and once at the ending location. A right click will lift the pen, but will leave you in the draw mode. You do not have to snap to grids and may draw anywhere in the plan. And note that the member is dynamically dimensioned as it is drawn. There are also a number of drawing controls available, including fixed length, parallel to angle, parallel to X, and parallel to Y. The letters in the parentheses indicate the hotkey letter to activate this option. If we hit the X key while drawing, the line will be parallel to X no matter where the cursor is. Similar control if we hit Y. Or A. Here we set the angle to 45 degrees. If we switch to the 3D view, we can also draw frames with the same command. For 3D views, a working plane identifier is displayed. If none is selected, frames may only be drawn in 3D when the cursor snaps to an item, such as grid lines or other member ends. If we switch to a particular working plane, such as Story 2, then the program understands that everything is to be located in a particular plane, and we do not need to snap to other objects. Note that the objects show up in the plan view. Click the Select Object button to leave the draw mode. The Quick Draw Beams Columns command allows us to generate a beam on a grid with a single click, or a number of beams by using a selection box. If we set the drawing and selection drop-down lists to all stories, adding an object at any level will add the same object to all levels. In the 3D view, we can add columns by clicking on a grid. Note that all stories is still active. Or add a number of frames at grids using a selection box. If at some point you wish to change the assigned property, you may do so by going to the Model Explorer window and on the Model tab, expanding the Properties branch, and then the frame sections. Simply grab the desired section and drag and drop it onto the frame member. The Quick Draw Columns command allows us to create columns anywhere in a plan view with a single click. Note the intelligent snap lines drawn to help locate the columns. Columns may also be added at grid intersections with a selection box. In a 3D view, columns may be added at grid intersections or at other locations if a working plane is selected. Once frames are drawn, there are a number of ways to edit and modify them. For instance, if we select the end joint on this frame, we can move it by going to the Edit menu Align Joints command. If we select the Align Joints to X ordinate option at 0 feet, the end joint will be shifted over to the Y axis. We could have also moved an end joint by using the interactive editing tables. A right click shows this joint name to be 1. If we go to the Tables tab in the Model Explorer window, expand the Structure Layout branch, and then open the Joint Coordinates table, we can edit the X location of joint 1. We enter 24 and click Apply. The end of the frame moves over. Next, we will trim off the segment of this frame that extends past the intersection point. We do this by selecting the frame to be trimmed, the end joint on the side to be trimmed, and the intersecting frame. Next, we go to the Edit, Align Joints Frames command, and select the Trim Frame Objects option. To create secondary beams, simply click in a region bounded by grid lines. This drawing tool is best used in plan views. The orientation may be in the Y direction, the X direction, or in a direction normal to the edge nearest your click. This last option makes quick work of adding miscellaneous framing. The Quick Draw Braces command allows bracing to be added with a single click. This can best be done in plan or in elevation. The program offers a number of different bracing orientations. Next on the list of drawing tools are the shell objects. The Draw Floor Wall command allows us to draw a completely arbitrary closed polygon in plan, where we can use snaps or no snaps to lay out the geometry. Note that the Draw Floor Wall command has the same drawing controls for edge control as the frame objects did, including the parallel to X and parallel to Y options. This same command can be used for drawing walls in an elevation view. The draw rectangular floor wall command allows us to generate floors or walls by clicking and dragging a box. These boxes may be any size, and if the X dimension and Y dimension values are set, they may be created with a single click. This feature is handy for creating repetitive items such as footings and drop panels. And although all of these objects were just drawn as rectangles, they may easily be changed to another shape by using the Reshape Object tool. Click the shape and then drag the handles. The quick draw floor wall command allows us to create floors or walls in a region bounded by grid lines with a single click or with a selection box. This same quick draw floor command also allows for floors to be drawn using the perimeter outline formed with lines. We just saw how walls can be drawn in the elevation view. But wall objects may also be added to the model in the plan view. The Draw Walls command allows us to create walls of any orientation. And offers the same drawing controls as the Draw Frame command. The Quick Draw Walls command allows walls to be added on a grid with a single click or on multiple grids by using a selection box. We can also create a wall off the grid by using the Plan Offset Normal option. A very powerful tool for adding assemblages of walls is the Draw Wall Stack command. This feature allows predefined wall layouts to be added to the model with a single click. The layouts are parametrically driven, meaning that the dimensions and thicknesses may be edited. Like when drawing other objects, a properties of object form is displayed, and here the angle and the range of stories for the wall stack may be set. ETABS modeling is done at the physical level, meaning that objects are drawn as they appear in the physical world and then meshed internally into analytical elements by ETABS utilizing a sophisticated automated meshing scheme. However, on occasion, the user may wish to divide the objects themselves into smaller sizes. For floor objects, one option is to select the shell object to be divided, and then the frame object used to divide the floor. Click on the Edit menu, Edit Shells, Divide Shells command, and select the Cookie Cut Floor Objects at Selected Frame Objects option. The floor object has been divided into two. Select another floor object, as well as a point. Go to the Divide Shells again, and click on the Cookie Cut Floor Objects at Selected Joints and specify an angle. The object will be divided based on a line originating from the point at the specified angle. Select a floor object again, and go to the Divide Shells one last time. Select the Divide Quadrilaterals option, where you can specify the number of elements for subdivision. Two floor objects may be combined into a single object by selecting the two objects and going to the Edit menu, Edit Shells, Merge Shells command. Throughout this tutorial, we have had the Snap to Grid Intersections and Points option on. However, there are many other snap options available that help in accurately placing the position of the cursor when drawing, including Snap to Line Ends and Midpoints, Snap to Lines and Edges, Snap to Intersections, and Snap to Perpendicular Projections. Snap controls are also available under the Draw menu. This concludes this tutorial on drawing in ETABS.